Today I'm going to be showing you guys how to make a Lichtenberg sign. Please enjoy. First off, we're going to cut off a 2 foot section of this 3/4 inch by 11 1/4 inch wide red oak from Lowe's. So now we are going to sand it to 220 grit. Start off with 120. I always put painter's tape on the back. Makes it more durable. Lasts a lot longer. There we go. Now we just pick what side we want, the grain pattern that we want, and how we want it laid out. I'm liking this side up, and I simply lay it out on Microsoft Word. That's an old Iowan font, bold. And print it out. After you print it out, I'll get the center lines. Horizontally and vertically. And I'll do the same on the board. After we get those, I'll cut it out. I like to use wood glue. It's a little bit thicker. And you'll see why in a little bit. It'll protect from the, when we paint this, it'll protect from the bleeding. You only want a little bit. Too much will make this paper wrinkle. And we simply line up our lines. Now we just flatten it out so there's no wrinkles. And then positioned it where all of the lines are as close as possible. If you get some that are offset, you might have measured wrong, just meet in the middle. And we're gonna let that dry. Okay, I've let this set for about an hour. It's nice and dry. And I got a 1/8 inch bit in here. You can set the depth for whatever you want. I like to go about probably 3/16, a little over 1/8 of an inch deep. Set it about there. And simply stay within the lines and route it out as close as possible. I like to work the outside edges first and then hog out the middle. There we go. Okay, now that we got that complete, We're gonna take the sander with the 120 grit sandpaper and pull off this paper and see what we got. This is not perfect. Don't worry about it being perfect. Just stay in between the lines because you can take more off, but you can't add more. So we'll sand this off, see how it looks, and we'll touch it up if it needs, which it definitely will. It always does. But we'll go from there. Okay, now from there, we want to reset the router bit because we sanded some of the paper off. It's going to be a little bit more shallow. So how I do that is you can't push it, so it's sticking. So it's the bit's too deep. So I'll take off the lock. And now I can move it around. And just when it releases, that's where you want it. Because if you don't do that, you're gonna have a lot more sanding to do in the places where you go in and fix. So we'll go touch up a few places. Okay, that's it. When you're sanding the paper off, leave the glue on there. This is going to protect it from the paint bleeding into the grain. Just leave a little bit on there. You will sand it out here in a little bit. Okay, now that that's complete, I'm going to take this little wood carving tool and some sandpaper and clean up the insides, the edges, pull out all the little burrs. You want to get this as clean as possible before you spray paint, because you can't go back. You can spend as much time as you want on that step. The more work you do, the cleaner it'll be. I'm happy with this. All the little burrs are router marks. If you don't get those out, it will kind of show through on the paint. So the more work you put into it, the better it'll look. And now we're going to paint it. I left the glue on there so the paint will not bleed into the grain. That's why I left a little bit of glue on there. Then we'll sand off the paint and the glue to get our final product. You want to spray it on all four angles so you're getting on it in all four sides of each letter. I usually cover it up to keep as little amount of overspray on the board. So you just want to give it a light little coat. Just don't overdo it here. Now I'll let that dry for about 30 minutes to an hour, and we'll come back.